everyone, this is Vinitha Mimutum and you are watching Immuni Live Top 20 News. 13th August, the death anniversary of Beat Dikendrajit has been declared as official holiday. Dobokha Students Union and different organizations of Hojai district along with villagers of Dobokha protested against project undertaken by the Assam government for building National Highway 4 lane by cutting over 6,000 trees from Dobokha Reserve Forest today, as informed by our Hojai correspondent Samura Lakpam Hemanta Sharma. The Election Commission to arrange webcasting in all the 1,135 polling stations during 30th of October by election in Assam. The officials will be monitoring the polling process live through webcasting to ensure free, fair and safe polling. Pre-matric and post-matric scholarships for OBCs, SCs and economically backward class students were distributed by the Manipur Chief Minister Shri N. Biren Singh at Chief Minister Secretariat today. Aastha Chaudhary from Assam won gold in the 200-meter butterfly women's event at the 74th Senior National Aquatic Championship. Tripura Congress staged Gan Dharna, a mass protest in Agartala today, demanding action against perpetrators responsible for recent attacks on minorities. The Supreme Court has ordered ban on firecrackers. Justice M.R. Shah stressed that it is not against any particular festival, but it is also essential to protect the right to life. Sarthak, the Indian Coast Guard ship, was commissioned and dedicated to the nation today by the Director General of Indian Coast Guard, K. Natarajan, at Goa. Minister of Housing and Urban Affairs, Shri Hardeep Singh Puri, to inaugurate the 14th Urban Mobility Conference 2021 on 29th of October. Mobility for All is the main theme of the conference, focusing on to provide equitable access and promote inclusive urban transportation. The 73rd Battalion of BSF opened fire in a drone which was spotted at around 12:30 a.m. near the Shahpur border outpost in Punjab today. The Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya, JNV, at Madikeri in Kodagu, Karnataka, has been declared containment zone after 33 students of the school have tested COVID-19 positive. A minibus travelling from Thathri to Doda fell into a gorge today, in which 8 people were killed and several others got injured. The Prime Minister Narendra Modi has announced an ex gratia of Rs 2 lakh each to the next of kin of those who have lost their lives and Rs 50,000 to those who got injured in the accident. A 2.8-kilometer-long steel flyover to be completed by December 2022 at Hyderabad's RTCX roads. According to the GHMC, almost 75% of the bridge foundation have been completed. Sunao Suboi, a survivor of Hiroshima atomic bomb attack and Japanese campaigner against nuclear weapons, has died at the age of 96 on 24th of October due to an irregular heartbeat caused by anemia. Mukhyamantri Ghasiyari Kalyan Yojana to be launched by Union Home Minister Amit Shah on 30th of October at Banu School, Dehradun. The objective of the Yojana is to eliminate the burden of more than 3 lakh rural women of the state living in mountainous regions. Taiwan's President Tsai Ing-wen has confirmed the presence of US troops to train with Taiwanese soldiers on the self-governing island that China considers its own. The 50-year-old entrepreneur Elon Musk, soon to make history by becoming the first person in the world with a net worth of $300 billion after the recent spike in Tesla shares. 500 firefighters has been deployed by China to tackle forest blaze in Tibet. It was reported that forest fire broke out yesterday shortly after midnight, prompting the evacuation of about 50 local residents from the nearby villages. Kanha Chandra Barua and Deepti Barua Memorial Inter-Club and Educational Institution Athletics Meet of Guwahati Sports Association to be held at Indira Gandhi Athletics Stadium on 6th of November 2021. Today's Assam COVID-19 update. Total positive cases 322, recovery rate 98.40%, total death 2. That's all for today. Thanks for watching ImmunoLife.